Mixed fractions are nothing but a mixture of a whole and a proper fraction. So, some of the examples of a mixed fractions are, let's say, 2, 1 by 3, or 4, 2 by 7, or I can take it as 1, 1 by 3. So, these are some of the examples of a mixed fraction. Out of it, this part is known as the whole. And this 1 by 3 is regarded as the proper fraction. So, this is nothing but whole and a proper fraction. If I try to visualize this, that means if I say I am having 1 by 3 of pizza, that means I am having one whole pizza and a similar pizza, same size pizza is there, and I am having one part of it out of 3. So this is one whole and 1 by 3. It means 1 plus 1 by 3. If I take LCM, I'll be able to solve 3 by 3 plus 1 by 3, that is 4 by 3. So, mixed fractions have been derived from improper fractions. Let us try to understand from another perspective. So, 3 into 1 is 3 plus 1 is 4. So, it will be giving you 4 upon 3 only. So, this is a visual way. How do I get 4 upon 3 from the visual way? How many parts I am dividing this pizza in 3 equal parts? So, I will be dividing it into 3 equal parts. So, that means I am having 3 out of 3. And here I am having 1 out of 3. So, 3 plus 1, 4. 4 out of 3. So, either way, the answer is improper fraction. That is 4 upon 3. Suppose you have to convert mixed fraction to improper fraction. So what I have to do, I have to multiply these two numbers and add the result to the top. So 3 times 2, 6 plus 1, it's 7 upon 3. Similarly here, 7 times 4 is 28. 28 plus 2 is 30 upon 7. These are two improper fractions. We have discussed them in the previous classes. Improper fractions are when numerator is greater than denominator. This is the definition of improper fractions. Suppose another question comes that we have to convert improper into mixed fractions. So, let us try to understand by one method. We will be dividing numerator inside and denominator outside. Okay. So, this is 7 inside, 3 outside. So, write the table. Do not go into decimal parts. So, 2, I will be getting 6, 1. So, mixed fraction form is QR upon B. Mixed fraction form is Q R upon B. So this is quotient Q and this is remainder and this is divisor. So Q R D, that means 7 upon 3 can be written as Q is 2 wholes and 1 upon 3. So this is the mixed fraction form if they ask you to write it. Let us do this part also. If I divide these two, 30 and 7. So 7, 4 is 28, remainder is 2. So QRD is quotient is 4, remainder is 2 upon 7. So this is the mixed fraction for this improper fractions. So multiple type of questions can come. Suppose a mixed fraction form is given as 2, 7 upon 5. As we have discussed in the beginning of the topic, mixed fraction is nothing but whole and a proper fraction. Whole and a proper fraction. Whole and a proper fraction. But this is whole and an improper fraction. So we have to rewrite in the mixed fraction form in a proper way. I'll be showing you two ways. Okay. One is a very normal way, long way, that you multiply these two, it will be 10. 10 plus 7, 17 upon 5. Then you divide them. Okay. So 17 is 3. It will be 15. I'll be getting a 2. So answer is QRD. Quotient is 3. Remainder is 2 upon 5. So we will be getting a rewriting form as 3, 2 by 5. That's the answer. So I am going to show another method which will be helpful in doing a whole lot of calculations very easily. So try to understand that. So as we already know, mixed fraction is nothing but whole and a proper. So we know this thing, whole plus 2 by 7. This is 2 plus 1 by 3, whole and 1 by 3. This is whole, 2 plus 7 by 5. Write it this way or think it this way. But this is what? Improper fraction. So improper fraction can be converted into a proper fraction without even division. See, this is very easy to do. I can write it as 5, 1 and 2. Okay, 5 times 1 plus 2 remainder. Now, what I can do, I can rewrite it as 2 plus 1 plus 2 by 5, because any improper fraction, or sorry, any mixed fraction can be written as this way. So 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2 by 5. If this can be written as this way, so this can be written as this way. So I can write it as 3, 2 by 5. So you must be thinking this is a very long method. But don't worry, if I have to do, I will be doing it like this, in mental calculation. 7 by 5 is 1, okay, 2 by 5, and plus 1 is 3, so 3, 2 by 5. See, in one step I can do. I am just right now showing you how to do it, that's why it is looking longer. So either way, both the methods are okay, but if you want to improve your calculations in case of addition and subtraction of mixed fractions, this method will be handy. So you will be getting other videos linked related to how to fasten your calculation related to mixed fractions, addition, subtraction. You will be able to see the link in the card or in the description box, or you can check out the playlist. So thank you for watching. See you in the next video.